11月3号是美国总统选举，适逢新冠疫情肆虐美国全境，特朗普如何引领国家渡过难关，将决定他能不能蝉联总统宝座。让他头疼的是，所提出的防疫策略都饱受媒体批评，让他急跳脚说，有些媒体恨不得看他败选。
美国卫生部最新数据显示，全美确诊病例超过60000人，累计死亡病例增加到809人。眼见疫情失控，社会各界将矛头指向特朗普政府。在白宫的疫情汇报会上，媒体引述哈佛环球医疗学院院长阿西斯的谈话，认为卫生部门应该为所有美国人进行病毒检测。这番言论惹怒了特朗普。
And if not, how many deaths are acceptable?
Yeah. How many? None. Okay. How many deaths are acceptable to me? None. We have tested by far more than anybody.We're testing more than anybody right now. There's nobody even close. And our tests are the best tests. They're the most accurate tests. But if you're saying we're going to test 350 million people, I watched his statement. I disagree with it. We don't have to test the entire state. I think it's ridiculous.
特朗普和媒体的交锋还没停止。他接着说，希望全美国可以在4月12号的复活节恢复正常生活以及全面复工。媒体又呛声特朗普急着让人民复工的原因是想着为自己蝉联总统而铺路，他这样回击。
I think there are certain people that would like it not to open so quickly. I think there are certain people that would like it to do financially poorly because they think that would be very good as far as defeating me at the polls. I do think it's so that that there are people in your profession that would like that to happen. I think it's very clear. I think it's very clear.That there are people in your profession that write fake news. You do. She does. There are people in your profession that write fake news.
民调显示，新冠病毒疫情和经济衰退是特朗普连任的两大挑战。如今他和媒体的关系日益恶化，看来闯关的难度更高了。马新社电视综合报道。